It starts with AI infrastructure layer and our approach to Azure as the world's computer. You know, we offer the most comprehensive global infrastructure with more than 60 data center regions, more than any other provider. Being the world's computer means that we need to be even the world's best systems company across heterogeneous infrastructure. We work closely with our partners across the industry to incorporate the best innovation from power to the data center to the rack to the network to the core compute, as well as the AI accelerators. And in this new age of AI, we are redefining everything across the fleet and the data center. So let's start on how we power the data center. As we build them, we are working to source renewable power. In fact, today, we are one of the largest buyers of renewable energy around the globe. We have sourced over 19 gigawatts of renewable energy since 2013. I mean, just to put that in perspective, that's the equivalent to the annual production of 10 Hoover dams. And we're working with producers to bring new energy from wind, solar, geothermal, and nuclear fusion as well. And as we pursue this ambition to not just be carbon free, but to even erase our historical carbon emissions, I'm really excited to share that we are on track to meet our target of generating 100% of the energy we use in our data centers from zero carbon sources by 2025. Now, let's talk about the network that connects our data centers. It's one of the most advanced and extensive in the world already, and to meet the demands of AI and the future workloads, we're driving up the speeds. Our breakthrough hollow core fiber technology is delivering a 47% improvement in speed because photons are able to travel through these microscopic air capillaries instead of through solid glass fiber. This is really cutting-edge technology. In fact, we are manufacturing this fiber ourselves in the world's only dedicated factory for hollow core fiber production. Our first deployment, in fact, is already live, connecting our data centers in the United Kingdom. We are very, very excited about this. And now, let's just step right into the data center. Today, I'm excited to announce the general availability of Azure Boost. You know, it's fantastic to see this new system that offloads server virtualization processes onto purpose-built software and hardware. This enables massive improvements in networking, remote storage, and local storage throughput, making Azure the best cloud for high-performance workloads while strengthening security as well. Now, let's go inside our servers. We're tapping into the innovation across the industry, including from our partners AMD and Intel, and making that available to you. For example, organizations like Vestas use AMD on high-end compute and memory-optimized servers in Azure to run simulations on massive amounts of weather data. And the largest SAP database deployments are powered by our new MVV3 virtual machines running the fourth generation of Intel Xeon scalable processors, supporting up to 32 terabytes of memory. In fact, Intel's putting their own SAP instances on these machines, and it's great to see. You know, as a hyperscaler, we see workloads, we learn from them, and then get this opportunity as a systems company to optimize the entirety of the stack, from the energy draw to the silicon to maximizing performance and efficiency. And it's really thanks to this feedback cycle that I'm thrilled to introduce our very first custom in-house CPU series, Azure Cobalt, starting with Cobalt 100. Cobalt is the first CPU designed by us specifically for the Microsoft Cloud. And this 64-bit 128 core ARM-based chip is the fastest of any cloud provider. And it's already powering parts of Microsoft Teams, Azure Communication Services, as well as Azure SQL as we speak. And next year, we will make this available to customers. Yeah. And when it comes to AI accelerators, we're also partnering broadly across the industry to make Azure the best cloud, no questions asked, for both training and inference. It starts with our very deep partnership with NVIDIA. We have built the most powerful AI supercomputing infrastructure in the cloud using NVIDIA GPUs. And OpenAI has used this infrastructure to deliver the leading LLMs as we speak. In fact, last week, Azure was the largest submission to MLPerf benchmarking consortium with 10,000 H100 GPUs, three times more than the previous record, delivering better performance than any other cloud. And in the latest top 500 list of world supercomputers, Azure was the most powerful supercomputer in the public cloud and third all up. That made news. What didn't make news is we didn't submit the entirety of our supercomputer. We submitted only a fraction of our supercomputer. So I'm thrilled to be number three with that. And by the way, that's the only one that made the list as a public cloud. And as we build supercomputers to train these leading large models, InfiniBand gives us a unique advantage. And today we are even going further. We're adding NVIDIA's latest GPU AI accelerator, H200, to our fleet to support even larger model inferencing with the same latency, which is so important as these models become much bigger and more powerful. The ability for us to have these new generation of accelerators is a big deal. We are also introducing the first preview of Azure Confidential GPU VMs, as you can run your AI models on sensitive data sets on our cloud. We co-designed this with NVIDIA. So if you're doing what is referred to as retrieval augmented generation, or RAG, you'll hear a lot about this throughout the conference. Running on this confidential GPU VM, you can enrich, for example, your prompt with very query-specific knowledge from proprietary databases, document archives, while keeping the entirety of the process protected end-to-end. And so it's very exciting to see us not just lead with GPUs, but lead with GPUs with confidential computing. Now let's talk about AMD. I'm excited to announce that AMD's flagship MI300X AI accelerator is coming to Azure to give us even more choice for AI-optimized VMs. With 192 gigabytes of high bandwidth memory and 5.2 terabytes per second of bandwidth, the MI300X offers industry-leading memory speed and capacity. Again, this means we can serve large models faster using fewer GPUs. We've already got GPT-4 up and running on MI300X, and today we are offering early access to select customers. And we're not stopping there. We are committed to taking the entirety of our know-how from across the system and bringing you the best innovation from our partners and us. Today, we're announcing our first fully custom in-house AI accelerator, Azure Maia. Starting with Maia 100, designed to running cloud AI workloads like LLM training and inference, this chip is manufactured on a 5-nanometer process, has 105 billion transistors, making it one of the largest chips that can be made with current technology. And it goes beyond the chip, though. You know, we have designed Maia 100 as an end-to-end rack for AI, as you can see right here. AI power demands require infrastructure that is dramatically different from other clouds. The compute workloads require a lot more cooling as well as their networking density. And we have designed the cooling unit, known as the Sidekick, to match the thermal profile of the chip and added rack-level closed-loop liquid cooling for higher efficiency. This architecture allows us to take this rack and put it into existing data center infrastructure and facilities rather than building new ones. And by the way, they're also built and manufactured to meet our zero waste commitments. So we are very, very excited about Maia. With Maia, we are combining the state-of-the-art silicon packaging techniques, ultra-high bandwidth networking design, modern cooling, power management, algorithmic co-design of both the hardware and the software. And we're already testing this with many of our own AI services, including the GitHub Copilot. And we will roll out Maia accelerators across our fleet, supporting our own workloads first, and we'll scale it to third-party workloads after. This silicon diversity is what allows us to power the world's most powerful foundation models. And all of our AI workloads, from Copilot to your own AI applications, so that when I say systems, this is the end-to-end innovation. From glass blowing the next generation fiber optic cables, sourcing renewable energy, designing new approaches to thermal distribution, innovating in silicon, our goal is to ensure that the ultimate efficiency, performance, and scale is something that we can bring to you from us and our partners.